So I don't really know how to start off this video. It is time for Bleach episode 17, Heart of the Wolf. And, you know, if you know in the manga what's about to happen in this episode, it is going to be a turning point for me and especially for my girl Bambietta. I don't really want to get into it because I'm pretty sure we're going to find out this episode and I don't really want to spoil, but I'm extremely dreading this episode. Also, I guess we could talk about is the CGI as well and what we're to be expecting of CGI, because, you know, people are going to, I guess, be more critical of it considering how big this fight is and especially how emotional this fight is going to be. But hopefully people are going to enjoy the CGI. Hopefully I'm going to enjoy it. So let's get into it, shall we? Because I'm excited to see what this episode has to bring us, as I am every episode. So with that being said, let's get into this episode of Bleach and F's in chat for Bambietta. So with that being said, if you like these reactions, please hit that like and subscribe and let's get into it, shall we? Ori starting off with an explosive start. We'd love to see that. Oh, candies! And of course, Giselle. At least we get to see what their wings, Quincy Ball standing wings look like. Hey, Meninas! The voice acting for Letoto. It's still interesting to hear. Bambi is looking furious! I love it. I'm anxious. Bambietta is looking great so far. Ooh, clean! Shinji. yo, Mandin. Man didn't even. The double tap. Yo, Shinji didn't even see it coming. Wow. Okay. That was. Ah! She said the BBS line. Oh, she looks great. Oh, this is already, that was way better than in the manga, I'm not gonna lie. The way Shinji just got dropped. Hey, Momo! Oh, Bambi's looking furious. Come on, Momo, what are we gonna do? She got saved, okay. I mean, yeah. Why was I expecting her to do something? Oh, she's quick, though. She's really quick. Oh, the music's great, too. This is looking great so far, holy. Ooh, what's up with the hand? And my only is. Ah, Bambi! You look so good. Hey, they've done us so good this episode. Let's have a look inside that bucket. Ooh. There he is! There he is! The goat! Look how handsome my man's looking! You're not a dog anymore. Nah, he's an attractive boy. The werewolf clan was sent to the hell of beasts for the sins we committed during our lifetime. Are we going to elaborate on that, Kubo? Tear out your heart with your own hands and offer it to me. If you do, I will teach you the Jinka no Jutsu. Of course he has an obligation to throw his life away for the Soul Reapers, because, you know, it was Yamamoto that gave him, you know, a position in life anyway. So, yeah, as he says here, Gemiroso took me in. And this is why he wants to go to UR straight away. That man just went straight for it. Take your captain, Momo. Hey, she can lift her. She can lift a fully grown man. Pick me up like that. Hopefully this looks good. Okay. Was that added in the manga? Like the destructive damage of like the heaviness? Hey. Okay. Here we go. What is that? What is that indeed? Hey, looks fluid. Hey, come on. Yeah. This looks good. Legs. It's not working, Bambi. Hey, it looks good, you know. It looks good.
He's
taking the armor off and exposing only my spiritual pressure, my power. Yeah, this is fluid. God, imagine that rushing at you. But Bambi's fast. You can keep spamming it. Damn, ooh, the dodges. Yeah, and he is taking the damage too. Hey, take it off. Sheesh. Aww. I mean, it wasn't exactly panel for panel, but hey. The effects are really, like, pushing like this to elevated heights. Ooh, the heart's not there. at the art of temporary gaming, an immortal body, while I'm in the form of a human. So that's why he wanted to go to Yuha, because he's immortal. So could it? Oh, Bambi, don't get scared. I don't like seeing you like this. You gave up your life, aren't you fine? Because you'll die if you lose, because you could be killed. Yeah, and he's taking all that damage as well. Man, still with it though, not flinching or anything. Oh, is this the last strike? Ah, yeah, that was manga perfect. I love that. Ah, here we go. I guess you kind of forget how quick things are in the actual manga. But I felt like that covered pretty much everything. Oh! Oh no! Bambi! No! No! Bambi! Hey, that looked good though. That looks... this... Daigon Joe looks great. It really does. Oh, okay. Now he's looking toward... Ooh, look at the size difference. Like, from afar. Go get him, Kumamori. Go get him. Hey. Looking like a menace. Look at that. Imagine that charging towards your castle. And then, of course, this. Damn. It's almost silent, like no music or anything at the moment. Oh, not this song. Not this OST. Is this going to be a remix too? Come on, Mora, you got this. Oh no, not the canines coming out. Throwing away your life away for the sake of revenge. It's ironic, isn't it? Yeah. Damn, man. Not Komamura. It had to be this OST, didn't it? Ooh. That transformation looks good. This is beautiful so far. Soon your life as a human will end. It had to be this song, didn't it? It had to be. Not the flashbacks, man. Not the young Komamura flashbacks. It is ironic that what he preached was the thing that he, you know, eventually went against. Now, even I'm, like, feeling it a little bit now, you know? Like... As if, that's crazy. That's crazy that I'm actually feeling it, and I knew exactly. Not the title card, man. That's so sad. Like, I'm actually feeling it a little bit. That's crazy. Oh, Bambi got diffed. Komamori got diffed. Oh, that was beautiful. Who are you? Poshwald, maybe? Are you again? Well, that's new. The underboob? It's there. A little bit. Move the smoke! And now I'm on my fuck Gisela. I don't give a fuck what you call this fucking piece of shit. I fucking hate Gisela. I will go to the ends of the earth to stress how much I hate this piece of shit. How are you gonna end it like that though? With Bambi and Komamura. So I'm just completely ignoring the fact that, like, Hushwall versus Isane right now. Here we go, there's the hexagonal barrier that I was talking about a few episodes ago. Hey, Isane quick with the Kido, though. Very different. It means if it's weaker, then it contains a trap. That was a lovely effect. Quite like that. It was Uryu that got him, though. That was new, right?
<笑><笑><笑><笑><笑><笑><笑>
Fucking James, man. Bing. Yeah! Let's go! Hey, yo! Mask is doing numbers with them! Not like this! Oh, damn. Two, three, you're out of here!
It's only when you don't have an audience, isn't that right, James?
I agree, Mask. I agree. What's that? New foes, you are the foe, fam. His voice, like James's voice, is just really weirdly sounding. I don't know. Yeah, basically, that's how it. Oh, god damn, he got clotheslined. I certainly thought so. Damn. Let's go! Who's this? Big Kensei? Hey! With the hands in the pocket, absolutely looking dripped. Oh, Big Rose coming too? Tashi 2. For a big guy, Master Masculine is quite nimble. That's not how it's gonna end, surely. I mean, yeah, it makes sense. Okay, and the ending. I hate this episode. Post-end credits? Here we go, Ichigo again, which is surprising. We'll talk about that after the episode. So what's going on here? Are we going to get more info? Damn, look at the veins popping out of my man's fucking arm! The memories that spread throughout all things from the borrowed world. That is the power of the king. Mad. Okay, there's the colours. Are you a vessel that can withstand immense power? It's been poured like a cup that's been easily shattered. I'm in awe. Oh, it's Sutara. I forgot her name. Why are you at the end? Oh, so I'll just say, like, straight up, what an episode. Like, just what an episode. I mean, besides the Komamura Bambiata, which I have so much to say about that. I can't wait for the review to talk about that, but now I'm on my I hate Giselle arc. Like, there's nothing you can say to me that will ever consider this person just even a speck of positive things to say. Fuck Giselle. I mean, the mask stuff's cool, right? But, like, that Ichigo stuff was a bit mad. So I really, 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 really wanna go and, I'm processing so much. I really wanna go and, like, rewatch that for like the review, but I'm like look it's my live reaction on things, right? So everything's just kind of like just thoughts going through my head right now until like I actually like watch it again and like kind of take it all in. I felt like that was metaphorical. Like, obviously the power's going into his body, but like, is it actually staying in his body? It's like, again, if I carry on talking, I will actually just carry on waffling nonsense without actually understanding what I'm saying. But I felt like it was metaphorical. Like, the things were happening, but, like, not to, like, when people say, oh, yeah, he's got the Almighty. I don't think he's got the Almighty. Like, it was just a test. All of this was a test to see, obviously, for a potential thing that you'll learn from, like, the light novels about, like, what Ichibe has potentially planned for him. But I mean, if his body can't take that spiritual energy, then there's no point in him, like, proceeding forward. So it was a test to see if he could handle it, right? So I don't think what he's just experienced is still within him. I feel like it was just a temporary thing. But then at the end of the road, he gets straight to Sutara. But it seems like the pathway is done now anyway. And this is definitely going to be, I think, each episode from this point on, especially from like looking at the other animators, it's going to be like really high quality. This episode was really high quality as well. I actually really enjoyed this one a lot. This is definitely the best one of the season so far. And wow, just there's a lot to process. I really enjoyed that. So I'm gonna catch you guys later. Like, I got a lot to think about and a lot to rewatch, so I'm gonna catch you guys later. Bambi, please. I miss her. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine, Devin Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.